Hello guys, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today, in today's video, we are going to learn about the Frank Hertz experiment using our Tesca scripts. So basically, Frank Hertz experiment demonstrates that existence of excited states always takes place in mercury atoms. And this experiment also confirmed the quantum theory. As we know, that quantum theory explains that always electron quantize in discrete energy levels, that is n equals to 1, 2, 3 and so on. So in this experiment, we are going to verify some considerations that Frank and Hertz set in 1914, that it is possible to excite atoms by electron bombardment, and that energy transfer from electron to the atoms always takes place in discrete values, and the values as obtained in the energy levels in agreement with spectroscopic results. So now let's move on our kit, that is Frank Hertz experiment. I will discuss the different part of this kit, and later on I will explain the experiment that I perform in this video. So this is our Tesca kit, that is Frank Hertz experiment kit. Order code 19204401.1. And these are the different accessories that we provide with this kit. This is basically a vacuum tube cover. This is a vacuum tube. And this is a probe. And this is a user manual for better understanding for the experiment. So first of all, I am going to assemble these accessories on this kit. So first of all, I am taking vacuum tube and adjust this vacuum tube on this holder. So you can just see how I adjust this. So this is a adjustment of vacuum tube, and this is a glass cover for vacuum tube. So adjust this glass cover as given in this. So these all are set. Now I am going to explain different parts for this kit. What parts are given on this kit? Basically, this is a on off switch. These are the voltage adjuster and voltage knobs. So if we want to select the voltage VG1K, then we have to rotate this knob VG1K, and this voltage display in this voltage digital meter. And basically this is a scanning voltage which is used during the operation of CRO. This is a filament voltage to give the voltage to filament. These are the different terminals for getting the output on CRO, that is it is written there is a Y terminal, it is a ground terminal, it is a X terminal. This is a current multiplier switch to multiply the current. This is a current digital meter to display the current on this display. And this is a auto manual switch. So now I am detailing this experiment, that is Frank Hertz experiment. So first of all, I am going to tell you about the operating principle that I have used in this experiment. So the Frank Hertz tube in this instrument is tetrod filled with the vapor of experimental substance, which is shown in figure 1. This indicates the basic scheme for experiment. So this is a circuit diagram of Frank Hertz experiment. So basically, this is a schematic diagram for Frank Hertz experiment, and this is a vacuum tube. In this vacuum tube, we have one anode and one cathode, and in this we also have two grids, that is G1 and G2. These grids are wire mesh grids, and in this we have three types of voltage, that is VG1K, VG2K and VG2A. And we always make VG1K and VG2A constant, and VG2K is a variable, so that electron can accelerate from grid 1 to grid 2. So when electron pass through the G1, G2, this vacuum tube organ atoms get energized. So now I am going to performing the experiment on this kit, that is Frank Hertz experiment. So first of all, switch on the power on switch. After then, check all the knobs that all are at minimum position. So this is the filament voltage, it is at now minimum position. This is scanning voltage, take it on the minimum position. VG1K, VG2A, VG2K also at minimum position. So if you find negative current in the current display, then you have to wait for a 10 minutes so that the negative current becomes zero. So now turn on the manual auto switch to manual. So here it is on manual. Turn voltage display selector to VG1K. It is already on VG1K, and by using the VG1K knob, we have to select the voltage at 1.5 volt. So now I am going to selecting the voltage at 1.5 volt. Now select the voltage selector at VG2A and select the voltage by voltage knob at 7.5 volt. So as I have told you earlier that these voltages are constant voltage, and now we turn the voltage adjuster at VG2K and we accelerate the voltage by using the VG2K so that electron can pass to anode and cathode, and set the current multiplier knob at 10 to the minus 8 position. So I am selecting and see the filament voltage, take it to the medium position. So now it is at medium position. After then, what we do that we starting increasing the VG2K voltage so that the current can started increasing. And after every 1 volt, we note down the current reading, and again we increase the voltage. After again we note down the reading. So at 1 volt, 0. At 2 volt also 0, so till 9 volt it is 0. So now you can see that it is started increasing. So you note down the reading at 9 volt, it's showing 0.06 current. At 10 volt, it is 0.41. So continuously increasing this VG2K voltage till 90 volt, and in every 10 volt, in 10 or 11 volt interval, you will find one maxima and minima periodically. So now I am increasing this VG2K voltage, so that you see that it is increasing. So now you can see it is also decreasing now. So it is continuously decreasing, and after some time it at minimum position. So you can see. Now you can see it is also increasing. So I told you after every 10 or 11 volt interval, it is one maxima is there, one minima is there. So now it is increasing. So this is how till 90 volt we continuously increasing and decreasing. We continue to see the increment and decrement in the current. After note downing the readings, we have to plot the graph between the accelerating voltage, that is VG2K, and between the plate current. So this is how we find the graph, that is one maxima is there, one minima, one maxima, minima, maxima, minima. So periodically it is showing maxima and minima values. So what we have observed from this experiment, that a significant decrease in electron current is noticed every time the potential on grid 2 is increased by approximately 12 volt, thereby indicating that energy is transferred from beam in quanta of 12 electron volt only. Indeed, a prominent line in the spectrum of argon exists at 1048 angstrom, corresponding to electron volt equals to 11.83 volt. So the location of peaks is indicated in this graph, and the average value of spacing between peaks is 11.75 volt, and the accepted value of argon is 11.83 volt. observe the same graph that we get in the manual condition on the CRO. So by using the manual auto switch, we take the manual auto switch to auto, and by using the CRO probe, we connect the Y terminal, ground terminal, X terminal to CRO. So now we are connecting CRO probes to Y terminal. This is on X terminal and this is on ground. Now connect these two, Y to the Y channel of CRO and X to the X channel of CRO. So this is how I am connecting Y and X channel of CRO. So now you can see the connection. Now adjusted to XY mode. After then you observe a dot on the CRO display. So now what you have to do, come to the kit and just increase the, just start increasing the scanning voltage. So now you are observing same graph on the CRO. This is basically a auto mode of Frank Hertz experiment. So if you decrease the scanning volt also, the graph also start decreasing. So this is how we are observing our graph on CRO. Now we perform the experiment and we observe the output on auto and manual mode both. And for other queries, you can go through our manuals for difficulties and also contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Thank you.